Florida Power and Light is having a tough time keeping the power on for everyone, and that's left some out in the cold, quite literally. The lights and heat went out at this Boynton Beach apartment complex around 7 Sunday night. For residents, that meant packing on the layers and blankets just to stay warm.
We went to sleep early. There was nothing to do. I figured hopefully we'd wake up and there'd be power. I woke up about 7 and freezing. I was freezing. The little dog had to sleep with us all night.
So how are they faring right now? Well, Stefan Holt joins us with the answer. Stefan?
Tiffany's still very cold and very frustrated. Even more frustrating, people in the Dos Lagos community say they're not sure when the heat will be back.
He's just a baby. I was getting afraid last night. It was so cold and he was shivering and shaking.
A shivering, furry face poking out of a jacket. The only way for little Attila to stay warm.
At 7 o'clock and we're just hanging out and watching TV, doing our thing, and all of a sudden the power's out and you call FPNL and you can't get through to anybody.
But inside Dave Archer's home, it is absolutely freezing.
Doesn't work very well if you don't have any power. There's no hot water. I can't take a shower. I have no TV, no internet, nothing, no lights. All I can do is sit there, just basically sit there and try to stay warm.
And cooking is not an option either. Food in the fridge already starting to go bad. Across the street, some lights are on, but Dave and others are still literally left out in the cold.
She couldn't get her garage open because she has an electric garage door, so I helped her open her garage door to get out.
The lights may be on in the neighbors' homes, but at least 96 people are estimated by FPL to be out of power here in this community. They say they're working around the clock to get it restored, but with these frigid temperatures, records are being broken.
The power grid strained. FPL calling it the all-time record, 24,000 megawatt hours. It's leaving scattered outages and even more so, irritated customers.
Luckily, I'm young and, you know, I can pile the blankets on, and but, you know, older people in this kind of temperature, it could be very dangerous.
An FPL recording says power will be restored, quote, at the end of the day. But Dave says he's not holding out hope.
Is that 12:59 p.m.? I don't know. What's the end of the day? That's if it doesn't change.
And FPL says they have more crews out and about to try and restore power. They're also encouraging those with the heat to turn it down to 68 degrees when you're home, 65 when you're away or sleeping. They hope that will help alleviate some of the strain on the grid as frigid temperatures remain. Stefan Holt, WPBF, 25 News.